In the financial year under review, Uganda Revenue Authority was allocated a budget of 534 billion shillings, which was fully released, but the entity went ahead to spend more 34.7 billion shillings, which was an unspent balance accruing from the previous year, 2020-2021, without seeking Parliament's approval.
The institution that appropriates money to entities in this country is Parliament of Uganda. Parliament of Uganda appropriated 534 billion to URA. But now URA is saying we have some unspent balance of 34.7 billion. Finance, allow us to utilize this. As opposed to URA returning to Parliament, whether through the sectoral committee or through the ministry that supervises you, to come back to Parliament for appropriation. So you people decided on your own there with finance to carry out the appropriation mandate.
At what date did this take place? Because for funds to be asked to be retained, that could have been in June, maybe it was even the end of June. So at what point? Because by June, if it was in June, at the end of June, then that also will help us, because if it was the end of June, then we would have already passed the budget.
The COSASE chairperson, Joel Senyonyi, says, although it appears this was done under Section 14 of the Uganda Revenue Authority Act, which governs the institution, that law is subservient to the Public Finance Management Act 2015.
Of the URA Act. And I will quote a part of it. The minister may from time to time authorize the authority, that's URA in writing, to retain the percentage of revenue collected by the authority, as may be determined by the minister, in order to enable the authority to meet its expenditure without interruption. But the total sum so authorized shall not, in any financial year, exceed the amount appropriated by Parliament for the authority for that year, and shall be set off against the amount so appropriated. What was appropriated was 534. This 34 that you asked finance to allow you retain, and you received, at least as you say, the permission to utilize it, is not embedded within the 534. That's where I want you to help me understand how that happened.
Legislators on the committee argued that the Public Finance Management Act stipulates that clearance from Parliament is required to retain unspent funds, or else unspent balances are swept back to the consolidated fund.
This contradicts CG with what you had earlier on said, that you had written to finance, and finance was supposed to, because Parliament is the one which has the powers to appropriate, and then it was not granted, but there's a contradiction with the statement here.
Sorry about the mix-up on the two funds. For the 34, we were granted permission to retain, and therefore it's part of what we utilized. Where we are not granted is in the last financial year.
However, Uganda Revenue Authority officials noted that they followed all the due processes for approval, but couldn't commit to whether the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Planning indeed followed it up with Parliament.
The Honorable Minister of Finance writes to URA and gives us permission to retain that out of the collections. This is because of the nature and the urgency of the operations of revenue collection. So that's why we do not wait for the releases from the Treasury on a quarterly basis, like for other institutions, for us to be able to run, because there is no single day when revenue collection does not happen.
COSASE chairperson ordered the entity to table evidence that they wrote to the finance ministry by the close of business on Wednesday.
The law under which you were proceeding.
In the same vein, plans are in offing to grill officials from the executive to this effect.
Within what was appropriated by Parliament.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.